I'm not angry. Just go back. Over here, that it says...
Oh, yeah.
We just need a way to get on top. Just gotta be careful. Try not to be a dead person. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Alright. Right through there. That's where I need to fire my portal. Got it. Falling. Try not to die. Try not to die. Yeah. Whoa. Okay. Forgot I shot on the floor. That was disorienting. Alright, cool. So the funny thing is that when you, by the time you know what you're doing in this game, this final chapter is basically half of the entire game. But this is where the real game is, basically. You play it all out in a controlled testing environment to teach you how to use the gun in a tutorial fashion. Then the real game starts happening, where you then have to actually use your character to move forward and proceed and actually solve things with zero real guidance. Like, this is the game that follows the tutorial. And it's all cleverly put together, because it even feels separate.
Sorry for you, really, because you're not even in the right place. You should have turned left before. It's funny, actually, when you think about it. Someday we'll remember this and laugh, and laugh, and laugh. Oh. Well, you may as well come on back.
That's also, I think, why she suddenly transforms into a villain, whereas before, up to that point, she was just this weird, quirky thing. Is that she's more necessary as a villain all of a sudden, because now we're playing a game. We're not just learning how mechanics work. We're now actually properly learning. I mean, we're not learning how mechanics work anymore. We're actually properly playing a game for the first time, with stakes and a progression and a series of linear challenges. So she turns into this antagonistic force the moment the game transforms into being a proper game. That's really jarring when all the sound cuts out like that. Makes me feel paranoid all of a sudden. Alright. Things are getting darker. We're only getting further from where we're supposed to be. Hey, Ratman was here. He's got supplies to survive. Not a whole lot this time, just some open cans of beans. Not much else. But you know what? It's something. Makes you wonder what the hell happened to him, right? He seemingly made it this far.
Who are you searching?
Ow, ow, pain. Are you still there?
Hello.
So she's clearly trying very hard to kill us right now. Just in case you somehow fell for her ploys to trick you into thinking that she was actually totally going to let us go, this is one last little trap where she explicitly tries to murder you, just so you can be sure she's the villain. And she's so great. She's such a great villain. I love her. Where's my portal surface? Way over there? There we go. Ta-da!
You're not a good person. You know that, right? Good people don't end up here. Can you hear me?
Activated. Are you still there?
Wait, doesn't this one not have bullets? Yeah, this one doesn't have bullets. Because it's not built properly. You can see its magazines going off. I'm pretty sure that's the whirring of its bullet belt, I think. And it's just freaking out. Because it just can't shoot me or anything. Poor guy. You almost feel bad because I talk to children. But that's part of the ploy to probably to make them more effective in the battlefield, these nightmare-tested weapons. So the voice actor that plays GLaDOS, or GLaDOS, GLaDOS, is actually... Wait, is this where it came from? It's not, is it? Is it? Oh, right, because I came from this side in the first place. There's got to be like a door or something. Or maybe I'm supposed to go on top of there? The voice actor... actually, I think her name's Ellen McLean or something like that. She plays the fairy godmother in a YouTube series called Wish It Inc. That's actually on YouTube, and I thought was actually pretty alright. She's a relatively minor role. She's technically the leader of the entire group, but I think she's relatively minorly used, to be honest. But that's an interesting little thing, just to see her show up and stuff, because she is other stuff besides just the person who plays this character. Oh, here we go. But it was definitely, there's definitely certain elements of the characterization of these different roles that have been cemented more and more by Portal 2 specifically. Hi.
Don't. Please put me down.
Don't mind me, I just can't let you kill me. One of the striking things about this game to me is the fact that is the realization of how little time we actually get to spend with these characters. Just because the Portal 2 is so much longer by comparison, it takes these elements and extrapolates on them outward so much that it becomes so much larger. It's a whole lot more cake is a lie going on here. As usual, it seems that the Ratman chambers don't seem to be helpful for solving the puzzles, but they're there. Here we go! Gotcha. What's that bright spot? That's just the outside fans. Yep. Are we clear?
This is your fault. It didn't have to be like this. I'm not kidding now. Turn back, or I will kill you. I'm going to kill you. And all the cake is gone. You don't even care, do you? This is your last chance.
They're even listed as hazard identifications, because presumably you would try to let all your test subjects die. But this is one last time to remind you that you can't go in and out of this place. I mean, this is one last chance to remind you that everyone's gone, period, and that's it. Interestingly, is this animated as double hinged? No, it's not. It's not double hinged in the texture. That's funny. It wouldn't make much sense. But it is amusing to me. The hinge is on both sides? Oh wait, the hinge is on both sides. So a running joke of sorts about doors in video games is the fact that they open in both directions. Which is not how doors really work, really. So that's not how any door that I have works, for the most part. But in video games, there's a disproportionately large number of doors that open in both directions. And interestingly, this door in particular actually has the hinge on both sides. That's a cute little touch. It's probably just a save on it, on the resources, because they probably just used the same texture twice. Yes, they did. See? That little three claw mark there. And there's the same claw mark there, whatever you want to call that. So it's just the same wall. Repeating over and over again. But there's one last chance to remind you of the fact that everyone's gone, period. Something's gone horribly wrong. And it's actually a nice little indication of the fact that these are supposed to stop stuff that's not supposed to be in the lab from getting in and out. This is the more applicable use of that, rather than destroying testing equipment constantly. And it's probably its original intentional use before GLaDOS changed how they would handle things. And she's mad at me. She's mad at me. She has gotten displeased, so she's now firing rockets at me. Which are thankfully abusable, for letting me get around without dying, hopefully. Don't kill me. Alright, get the hell away from those explosions. Hello? Hello? So this is actually the part that I have the least memory of anything, is the entire exit part. Because they're not discrete test chambers, it's a long, continuous series of moments that I think are supposed to feel improvised. Right, we need to get through this glass. I'm sure we need to use the turret there. Oh, I created a continuous cloud again. Yay! Visual glitches. Ain't they grand? Gotcha. So now it fired through that portal. Let's get that out of the way real quick so it doesn't get me killed. And it shattered the glass. So now we have a new mechanic to deal with. I don't know if we deal with it much in this game, but it's there if we need to deal with it. Don't think I can make that jump. Is there a portal surface in there? I don't remember how to get through here exactly. I'm sure I need to. Do I need to pick up stuff and stack it up? Am I insane? I don't want to die. I don't give a crap. I'll stand on a computer if I have to. It's not exactly a companion cube, but it'll have to do for a moment, a sad moment here. There we go. Hello, murder propeller. How you doing? Don't mind me. Just gonna head right back through here. So yeah, this guy must have had a portal gun if he got through here, because he's taking the same path as me, but he doesn't have, without the same trick, so it should be impossible, I think. Gross. We're further cementing the idea that everything under this place is just ongoing toxic sludge and just a disgusting mess. And it has to load, apparently. You can't elegantly put all the loading screens in elevators if you have a level this long. Not with a tech that this was running on originally, at least. Nowadays, these levels feel small compared to most things, so the idea they had trouble loading is kind of baffling. That's how things age. Gross. So we're actually sliding around in this slop. And this is where the sound design gets a little bad, to be honest. Up till now, I'm often kind of happy with the sound design in Valve games, but this part's aged particularly poorly with these very loud, gloopy noises we're hearing that just sound awful. Let's go ahead and get out of here. This part, however, has aged fantastically, because this music is great. Shut up. You're not allowed to disagree with me. I'm controlling the show right now, and I'll turn it around. Listen here, you. There we go. So turrets are actually used in a relatively sparse manner in this particular game. Please put me down. They quickly establish the idea of, hey, go get behind the turrets, and then you can destroy them. And that, I feel like for most of the main game, they kind of don't go far beyond that concept. It kind of stops there. Whereas Portal 2, I think, has a lot of really nasty, nasty, nasty puzzles to throw your way involving these turrets. I'm actually amazed by how this game can simultaneously feels like this like revolutionary concept that pulled off all these things in a way that hadn't been done before and changed the genre, while simultaneously feeling like a tiny experimental game that didn't have the legs to fully explore what it was doing. The idea that it can feel like both is a bit of a surprise to me. I didn't think that was the feeling that I was going to come away with, but that is kind of what this game's place in history is that it was this experiment, which is extra weird because it incorporated the people who originally made the game Narbacular Drop, and that itself was a tiny experimental title that played with this idea. No. Time to start over. All right. That's not what I wanted to do either. No. Yes. Damn it. I always shoot in the wrong direction. Oh god. You disoriented yet? Gotta remember to kind of shoot ahead of you or you're in trouble. There we go. There we go. Ta-da! Did it. Big ol' nightmare death chamber. But yeah, turrets are interesting specifically for the concept of messing with... They're good for messing with the concept of where you're allowed to move in a particular level. Bye. But when just used as a sudden threat, they don't serve much purpose for puzzles, unfortunately. And that's kind of the extent of That's kind of the extent of how the main campaign of Portal 1 uses the turrets, unfortunately. Is as a minor threat. Which is fine, but ultimately, the concept had more legs than that. They just needed to expand on it. Because, honestly, there's not much puzzle solving to be done for the concept of just... I really blew that, didn't I? Let's get back up here and try again. Place it better. Gotta land in it. But the idea is that they should be used to prevent the player from entering certain areas of a level, specifically, because he can do clever things with that kind of limitation. But they're largely here to serve a completely different purpose. Oh, let's put you closer to the wall. There we go. Got stuck a little bit. In this game's case, I kind of think they're not meant to be a puzzle mechanic outside of maybe the first chamber they're introduced in. They're mostly a narrative mechanic of helping it be an expression of the evil of Gladys and her constant attempts to murder you. Because at the moment, she can't really reach you directly. There's not much of that going on. But she can keep sending turrets after you over and over again, and that's the best way to express her constant attempts to kill you unless you want to really heavily rely on fire. Which is, you know, technically also a valid approach. Now you start to get a sense of how massive this place is, which makes you wonder what the hell allows a place like this to exist, because this place is absolutely huge! Way bigger than the series of test chambers you originally went in made you think. They themselves were large, but this is seemingly endless by comparison. And then this happens. Yeah. Look at this infinite void. It's like a Death Star type location. It's one of those impossibly large locations that you see in Star Wars because it's science fantasy instead of science fiction. And there she is, at long last.
Well, you found me. Congratulations. Was it worth it? Because despite your violent behavior, the only thing you've managed to break so far is my heart. Maybe you could settle for that and we'll just call it a day. I guess we both know that isn't going to happen. You chose this path. Now I have a surprise for you. Deploying surprise in 5, 4. Time out for a second. That wasn't supposed to happen. Do you see that thing that fell out of me? What is that? It's not the surprise. I've never seen it before. Never mind. It's a mystery I'll solve later.
By myself.
Because you'll be dead. I wouldn't bother with that thing. My guess is that touching it will just make your life even worse, somehow.
Gladys is freaky because she looks like a woman that is hanging upside down. Like, that's her feet, and that curve there is, like, that's her legs, and that's her hindquarters, and that's her torso, and that's her head. Like, they specifically made her, like, human-shaped, which is freaky. like kind of human shaped. It's abstract and weird, but it's still there. Then you have these things are constantly flashing cake everywhere. Because she seems to be the equivalent of a robot that's just actually got insane. And she has these things hanging off of her. They're called cores. And they're weird. And because this game's a giant tutorial, this whole thing's a giant tutorial, even this part ends up being a tutorial. They introduce a fight to you, but they insist on making sure that you know how to kill it.
Where are you taking that thing?
Before you have to fight it.
Have I lied to you? I mean, in this room? Trust me, leave that thing alone.
That one's weird because it's just a purple dead one. It's not really reacting to you at all.
I am being serious now. That crazy thing is not part of any test protocol.
They also nicely framed the ceiling to help you put a portal directly above it. Because there we have it. Speaking of tutorialization, here's the furnace we use for the companion cube. We know how to use this already, because they taught us how. And they're making sure I know how to put this in it before we proceed. Because otherwise we would be in trouble. She's feigning ignorance, because that's what she likes to do. She likes to lie to me. It's her favorite thing, probably.
I'll tell you what that thing isn't. It isn't yours, so leave it alone. You're kidding me. Did you just set that aperture science thing, we don't know what it does, into an aperture science emergency intelligence incinerator? That has got to be the dumbest thing that-
Whoa.
Good news. I figured out what that thing you just incinerated did. It was a morality core they installed after I flooded the enrichment center with a deadly neurotoxin to make me stop flooding the enrichment center with a deadly neurotoxin. So get comfortable while I warm up the neurotoxin emitters.
That's bad. We killed the only part of her that had morals.
I can't shut off the turret defenses. Oh well. If you want my advice, you should just lie down in front of a rocket. Trust me. It'll be a lot less painful than the neurotoxin. All right. Keep doing whatever it is you think you're doing. Killing you and giving you good advice aren't mutually exclusive. The rocket really is the way to go. That thing you burned up isn't important to me. Make shoes for orphans. Nice job breaking it, hero.
Who are you?
This isn't brave. It's murder. What did I ever do to you? The difference between us is that I'm keeping the pain.
Hey, look at that thing.
You don't even care, do you?
What's wrong with your legs? Where are we going? Are you coming back? Oh, hey, you. Do you smell something burning?
Oh, you think you're doing some damage?
2+2 is...
In base 4, I'm fine.
Math jokes.
I survived this long because I was curious about your behavior. Well, you've managed to destroy that part of me. Unfortunately, as much as I'd love to know, I can't get the neurotoxin into your head any faster. I'd just like to point out that you were given every opportunity to succeed. There was even going to be a party for you. A big party that all your friends were invited to. I invited your best friend, Companion Cube. Of course, all your other friends couldn't come either because you don't have any other friends because of how unlikable you are. It says so right here in your personnel file. Unlikable. Liked by no one. A bitter, unlikable loner whose passing shall not be mourned. Shall not be mourned. That's exactly what it says. Very formal. Very official. It also says you were adopted. So that's fun too. Speaking of curiosity, you're curious about what happens after you die, right? Guess what? I know. You're going to find out firsthand before I finish explaining it, though, so I won't bother.
Well, here's the cake obsession right here. This guy's just exclusively talking about what the ingredients are for cake.
Nothing you've ever done isn't important to me. It's the fluid catalytic cracking unit. It makes neurotoxin. So deadly. Joking.
I'm kidding.
When I said deadly neurotoxin, the deadly was in massive sarcasm quote. I could take a bath in this stuff. It's not deadly at all.
To me.
You, on the other hand, are going to find its deadliness a lot less fun. Who's gonna make the cake when I'm gone? You. You're wasting your time. You don't have all the other feelings. What's your point anyway? Survival. Well then, the last thing you want to do is hurt me. I have your brain scanned and permanently wrapped up in case something terrible happens to you. Which is just...
That's you. That's how dumb you sound.
You've been wrong about every single thing you've ever done.
Including this thing. You're not smart. You're not a scientist. You're not a doctor. You're not even a full-time employee. Why did your life go so wrong? Are you trying to escape?
And that, more than anything, is perhaps the gladdest that everyone remembers. That densely packed bit of writing at the end. There's every little piece of evidence possible of, like, this dark, creepy character. Look, we're at the surface. So it was all a subterranean facility.
Thank you for assuming the party at current submission position.
That's a reference to the fact that I'm apparently laying on the floor with my arms at my sides. And I'm being dragged away. That wasn't originally in the game. That ending was added before Portal 2 came out, to indicate that that character keeps going on in the next game. So those freaked me out because they all seemed like they were in 2D. They're all facing the camera as we were flying around them. So a ton of those cores are actually 2D. These ones aren't, obviously, the ones directly in front of me. But as we went around the perimeter, those were all two-dimensional images being seamlessly integrated into the map. That's a freaky effect.
This was a triumph. I'm making a note here, huge success. It's hard to overstate my satisfaction. Aperture Science. We do what we must because we can. For the good of all of us, except the ones who are dead. But there's no sense crying over every mistake. You just keep on trying till you run out of cake. And the science gets done and you make a neat gun for the people who are still alive.
I'm not even angry. I'm being so sincere right now. Even though you broke my heart and killed me and tore me to pieces and threw every piece into a fire. As I burned, it hurt because I was so happy for you. Now these points of data make a beautiful line, and they're out of beta, we're releasing on time. I'm glad I got burned, think of all the things we learned, of the people who are still alive. Go ahead.
I prefer to stay inside. Maybe you'll find someone else to help you. Maybe Black Mesa. That was a joke, haha, fat chance. Anyway, this cake is great. It's so delicious and moist. Look at me still talking when there's science to do. When I look out there, it makes me glad I'm not you. I've experiments to run and there's research to be done on the people who are still alive. And believe me, I am still alive. I'm doing science and I'm still alive. I feel fantastic and I'm still alive. While you're dead, I will be still alive. And when you're dead, I will be still alive. Still alive. Still alive.